Greetings to my dear teacher and my dear friends. Today, me and my group will present you information about the historical events that took place in the Kanyan Kingdom. Kanyan Kingdom was established after the downfall of Kotte and Sitavaka kingdoms. The first king of the Kanyan Kingdom is Kimimalam Surya I. These events took place during his period. The tooth relic of Lord Buddha was brought from Delgamo Temple to Kandy. During his period, Kimimalam Surya married Queen Kusumasana as a technique to confirm the kingship legally. King Rajasinghe I was defeated by him with the help of the people of the upcountry. During the reign of Kimimalam Surya, Portuguese were given a bad defeat by him at the fight at Dantore. It is also said that Kimimalam Surya I took help from the Dutch to chase away Portuguese from this country. Kimimalam Surya also took measures to develop Buddhism in this country. As a result of this, higher ordinance was brought from Burma to this country. And also, Viharas such as Garhwalini Vihara, Lankathirtha Vihara, Riddhi Vihara were renovated by him.
Now, let's see the historical event occurred during King Senarath. In 1629, King Senarath divided the kingdom into three parts, namely Mathale, Over and Senkalagala, and entrusted them to his three sons Vijayapala, Kumarasinghe and Rajasinghe respectively. The most important incident of this region was the Battle of Kandinwala at 1630 between Sinhalese and Portuguese. It was fought between King Senarath and his sons Prince Maha Asthana against the Portuguese forces commanded by then Governor Constantino the Sa.
The second Rajasinghe is a very important character of the Kanyan Kingdom. One of the most important events of the King Rajasinghe's times was the exclusion of the Portuguese by the Dutch. It was paradox of the Kanyan Kingdom to seek the help another European power to escape the trouble of one European power. The Kanyan Kingdom realized that we still facing strict trouble because of the Portuguese. The Dutch did not care so much about the conversation of the people of the country, their religion and imposing the culture domination. Even so, one is still beyond the reach of the average person. The internal situation of the Kanyan Kingdom gradually became unstable.
Next, I am going to speak about incidents that occurred during the reign of King Milatama Surya II. During this period, the power of Aristobus was high. The Uposampada, which was declined, was re-began.
The events occurred during the reign of King Veeraparaka Narayan Singh and King Vijay Raj Singh are significant in the talking about historical event of the Kandy Kingdom. King Veeraparaka Narayan Singh was weak in public administration. Therefore, Kandyan aristocracy future developed their power during that period. After his death, his wife's brother, King Sri Vijay Raj Singh, came to the throne. King Sri Vijay Raj Singh reigned from 1739 to 1747. During that tenure, he tried to bring the Upasampada from Burma on the instruction of Venerable Valvitiya Saranankara Thero, but was unsuccessful. After the death of King Sri Vijay Rajasinghe, King Kirtisi Rajasinghe came to the throne.
King Kirtisi Rajasinghe became the king of Kandy in 1747. In this period of time, the Buddhist culture of Sri Lanka started to degenerate. On the instruction of Saranankara Thero, the king sent a messenger to Siam. As a result of that, the Siam ordination was started. The Dutch began to threaten the upcountry, and the king asked help from the English. And as a result, in 1762, John Fibers made the king, but it didn't succeed. And then the Dutch invaded the upcountry in 1765, but their goal didn't succeed. After that, the king signed a treaty with the Dutch to protect the peace in 1766, and from this treaty, in Dutch tried to break down the relationship that the king had with other countries.
Kirtisi Rajasingha was succeeded by his brother Sri Rajadi Rajasingha in 1779. During this period, Mallad temple was renovated and donated to Honorable Upalithera and other monks. During this period, King Sri Rajadi Rajasingha paid all homages to the devotees as a devoted king. King Rajadi Rajasingha ruled for 18 years.
During the reign of the King Sri Kum Rajasingha, there were some of the most intense conflicts took place between the king and the aristocrats in the history of the Kandy region. As a result of these clashes, about 20 aristocrats were killed by the king. Leuke Disave, Pilimatala Mahadikaram and Mallatte Parathara Thero were some of them. Ahalapura Mahadikaram was the most powerful aristocrat who quarreled with the king. The reason behind this is a secret affair with the queen of Sri Kum Rajasingha. In retaliation, the king sent him to Sabaragamu, where the first rebellion between the king and the aristocrats took place in 1814 in the Kandyan history. The culmination of this conflict was the assassination of Ahalapura Mahadikaram's family members by order of king. Himashi.
As we all heard, the famous Madhu Bandara was Ahalapura Mahanilame's son who was killed with his family. Due to this conflict, when the king fled, he was captured by a Kandyan aristocrat and handed over to the British colonel John Doyle. In this way, the end result of these conflicts was the abolition of Sri Lankan political role of the state corporation and allied institutions that had been existed in Sri Lanka for nearly 2,400 years. In 1815, British forces entered the city with no resistance, leading to the Kandyan Convention between British and the chiefs of the Kandyan Kingdom. The darkest day of Sri Lankan history, 2nd March 1815, at the place Mogul Maduwa, Sri Lanka became the colony under British rule. Hope you enjoyed our presentation. Thank you.